Today we've got some pretty terrible news from AMD and a sprinkle of Microsoft. What's up guys, I'm Snows and this is your boot sequence. Back when AMD had nothing to show for in the CPU market, we saw Intel thrive. And with that came the Intel Motherboard Planned Obsolescence Program. Buy a new motherboard every year or two if you want to upgrade your CPU. This wasn't super well received by the consumers, but we really had no choice if we wanted a high performance PC. It was especially painful when a few years later, a lot of tests proved that the first gen Z170 motherboards could in fact support later CPUs all the way up to the 9th generation. On the other end, we have AMD. Back in 2017, with the release of the first gen Ryzen, AMD made it clear that they didn't want to be greedy. They wanted to be the good guys and allow their AM4 socket to be usable for as long as they possibly could. That meant that the AM4 socket would support CPUs all the way through 2020. All you would really need to do is to update the BIOS when the time comes. This is one of the reasons why I was so happy when I bought my B350 motherboard for my Ryzen 7 1700, because it should support Ryzen's third generation CPUs too. But it looks like AMD isn't the only one calling the shots, and unfortunately, some of us AM4 300 series owners might need to upgrade earlier than we think. The motherboard vendor MSI just confirmed that their 300 series motherboards won't make it all the way to Ryzen 3000. An owner of an X370 Xpower titanium MSI motherboard contacted their support team to inquire about Zen 2, and they told him outright that they would not extend support to the next gen Ryzen 3000 CPUs. There could be a few reasons for that, and unfortunately, other motherboard vendors might follow suit. An anonymous source at a different motherboard vendor told Tech Power Up that Zen 2 has a steeper electrical requirement and that the 300 series of motherboards just doesn't meet it. What I don't like about this statement is that this is the same excuse that Intel gave between the 100 and 200 series of motherboards. And that was bogus because we have proof that someone ran an overclocked 9900K at 5.5 GHz on a Z170 board. In my opinion, I don't think this has to do with just the electrical requirements. We're apparently getting up to 16 cores on Ryzen 3000, and sure, 16 cores might draw up a lot more power, but what about the 8 cores Zen 2? What about the possible 12 cores? I mean, if I can overclock an 8 core CPU, I surely can run a 12 core at stock, right? On top of that, they say that B450 motherboards will support Ryzen 3000. But how does a B450 motherboard have better electrical management than an X370 Xpower Titanium, which is almost made for overclocking? I unfortunately think that this has some greedy undertones and I don't like it. I sure hope Asus won't do the same, because I'm not planning to buy a new motherboard. And if I'm forced to, I'll make sure to buy one from a motherboard vendor who didn't cut support for the Ryzen 3000 series. I hope AMD does something about this. Moving on, Microsoft is hosting another Inside Xbox event tomorrow, April 16th, and guess what they might be unveiling? You guessed it, or maybe not. It's the Xbox One S All Digital Edition. We've seen the leaks all over the place about this console, and right before the event, we even have the price for the console, at least the European price. It is said to be €229, which actually converts to around $260 US, and $350 Canadian. Oh my god, that's expensive. It's kind of odd for it to be that pricey, since you can find current Xbox One S's for around 250 bucks. And these come with a disc reader. I mean, you do get 3 games with the all digital, but it's pretty pricey. Personally, I hope that at least Microsoft will shed a little more light on their program codenamed Odessa, since we haven't heard from it in a while. For those who don't know what that is, Odessa is supposed to be a trade-in program for your disc games, so you can use a digital key for them. It would only make sense to provide a solution for those who might want the S, but don't want to lose their physical games. Next up, I just wanted to remind you guys that I take questions from the comment section for a segment on the videos. So if you have a question for me or you want my opinion on a topic, leave it down below. I'll pick one from this comment section. Just make sure to use the hashtag boot sequence. Let's just use that. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news today, guys. I know that there were only 2 subjects today, but I really wanted to go further on the AMD topic, and there wasn't a lot more during the weekend. It's kind of weird. Hopefully you still enjoyed. Don't forget to drop me a like as usual. You can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to this beautiful channel. Have yourselves a great day, stay frosty, and I'll see you on the next one. By the way, I switched from iPhone to Android. More info on that later.